Leonard Nimoy played scores of roles in a showbiz career which lasted more than 6 decades. But with his death on Friday at his Bel Air home at age 83, according to his wife Susan Bay Nimoy, he will be remembered and loved as a character known simply as Spock. With his stark dual haircut, the famous Vulcan hand gesture, which Nimoy developed, and the phrase, "Live long and prosper," Nimoy's Mr. Spock earned a place in the American psyche that will live on. The half-human, half-Vulcan Spock would define the culture-changing science fiction franchise Star Trek as powerfully as the captain of the U.S.S. Enterprise, James T. Kirk, leading man William Shatner. Nimoy would portray the character in the original TV series, animated series, comic books and 8 Star Trek feature films. Spock is even more representative of the show because he was so unique. So incredibly singular, says George Takei, who played helmsman Hikaru Sulu in the TV series. And that character was really, Nimoy's, creation. None of us had pointy ears or those eyebrows that would shoot up like that. We all got used to seeing those ears. Ironically, it took much persuasion for Nimoy to agree to put the ears on, and years to accept the success of the character once it became a worldwide phenomenon. When first approached to appear in Gene Roddenberry's NBC science fiction program Star Trek, Nimoy was on the rise in Hollywood, garnering parts in TV staples such as Bonanza and Perry Mason. He balked. I hesitated. I took my work seriously. Did I really want to put on those pointed ears? Nimoy recalled during a commencement address at Boston University in 2012. Eventually, he took the part. And playing the sole alien aboard a starship of humans was inspired casting for a man born to Yiddish-speaking Russian Orthodox Jewish immigrants in Boston's West End in 1931. Nimoy was used to feeling like the outsider. Nimoy would be nominated for 3 Emmy Awards during the show's 3-year run on NBC. Even after the original series ended in 1969 with faltering ratings, Spock and the rest of the Starfleet crew would grow even more famous in prolific syndication.